Hello guys, and welcome to Python programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. And today in this tutorial we are discussing about the merge sort algorithm. So we'll see how to sort the list of numbers using this algorithm. So this name merge sort tells that to sort the list of number we need to merge the list, but to merge anything we need divided parts, right? So to sort the list of numbers using this algorithm, first, we need to divide the list. After that, we need to merge that divided list. So this is how merge sort will work. First, we'll take a list and we'll divide it. Next, we'll merge that. Okay, so now we'll see what is merge sort. We'll learn more about this, okay? So the first is, this merge sort is divide and conquer algorithm. So this divide and conquer is an algorithmic strategy where what we'll do is we'll divide our problem into subproblems, then we'll find out the solution for that subproblem, then we'll combine that result and we'll get the output. So we already discussed about the quick sort, which is a divide and conquer algorithm, right? That algorithm is also based on this strategy. Here merge sort is also based on this divide and conquer algorithm. So that is nothing but first we'll divide the given list, next we'll conquer it, that is nothing but we'll find out the solution for the sublist, next and the last step we'll combine the result. So these are the three steps of divide and conquer strategy: divide, conquer and combine. In the first step we'll divide the list to sublist, then we'll find out the solution for that sublist and we'll combine the result. So here in the merge sort, idea is we'll split the unsorted list into sublist. We'll divide the given list to sublist until the sublist contains single element. As we know, if a list contains single element, that means that is sorted, right? So we'll divide the given list until it contains single element. Next step is merging. So we'll merge that, we'll sort that, and finally we'll combine the result. So I'll take an example so you'll get the clear picture. So now if anyone give you the list of numbers and ask you to sort them using merge sort algorithm, then okay, so here I'll take list of numbers. I'm taking random numbers here, and here we can see this is not sorted. So I'll take this list name as list 1. You can take any. So I'll take the index as, and these are all the index. So the first step in merge sort algorithm is we need to divide the given list. But the question is how to divide that. So what we can do is we can find out the middle element of this list 1, and then we can divide the list based on that middle element. So here to find out the middle element, what I am doing is I'll take the length of list 1, truncated division 2. Here we can see length of list 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 elements. So length of list 1 will be 7. Truncated division 2 will get 3. So that is nothing but 3 will be our middle element. Okay. So now I need to divide this list based on this index. So I'll divide the list like this. Okay. We got 2 sublists now. But here we can see still in this sublist contains 3 element or 4 element. I need to divide this until I'll get the single element in the list. Okay. So now again, I need to divide this sublist. So for that, I'll use the same strategy. That is, I'll find out the middle element and I'll divide that. So here index will be 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3. So to divide this sublist, here length is 3. 3 truncated division 2. So that's nothing but 1. So I'll get this as the middle element. So I'll divide the list like this. Here it will contain 20. This will contain 150. So here what I'm doing is I'm not including the middle element in the first sublist. This is the left part, right? In the left part, I'm not including the middle element. In the right part, I'm including the middle element. So here in the left part, I'm taking the element from the first index to the last but one index of the middle element. Okay, so here I'm taking till here as the left element. This will be right. Okay, that's why here I'll get 150 and here I'll get 20. And here I'll get, it contains 0, 1, 2, 3, right? So total 4. So this will be the middle element. So I'll get 40 and 10 here, 5 and 17 here. So I hope now you know how to divide the list. I need to find out the middle element. Here 2 is the middle element. So I'll take the left sublist as 40 and 10. So in the sublist, I'll take from the first element to the middle element. I'm not taking the middle element in the left sublist. Okay, I'm including that in the right sublist. So now again here we can see the first sublist. This contains single element, so no need to further divide it. But these three contains two elements, so I need to divide that. So now if I divide this 1 and 50, I'll get 1 and 50. Here I'll get 40 and 10. Here I'll get 5 and 17. It contains 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1 index. That is nothing but 2 elements. So if I divided true truncated division 2, I'll get 1. Okay, so this will be the middle element. So I'll take the first element as this and second element as right sublist. Okay, so now here we can see we got the sublist with the single element. So now dividing step is over. So we divided the list in such a way that now our sublist contains single element. Now we need to merge that. Okay, so next step is merging. So for merging, what I need to do is, so first here I'll take 1 and 50 because I'll start with this step. Okay, so if this is the one step, this is the second step, this will be the third step, right? So I need to start from here. So I need to merge these two first. Okay, 1 and 50. So I need to compare this 1 is less than 50 or not. Yes, right? So I'll write it as 1 and 50. I'll merge them. Next, I'll see 40 and 10. Here 40 is greater than 10. So that's why I need to write 10 and 40. 5 and 17. 5 is less than 17. Okay, so I can write it as 5 and 17. So I need to check the element which is present in the left sublist is less than right sublist element. So next, I need to take this 20 now and this now. So we are done with the combining this step 3. So I need to move to the next step now, step 2. Okay, so here we can see 20 and 1 and 50. So I need to first check whether 20 is less than 1. No, it is not. So remember that here I'm sorting the number in the ascending order. So first I want smaller number, right? So I need to check the value present in the left side. This will be the left side and this will be the right side. Okay, so whether 20 is less than 1. No, so I need to write 1 here. Okay, next again I'll check whether 20 is less than 50. Yes, so I need to write 20 here. So now remaining element is 50, I need to write here. So now I'll move on to this side and here we have these two sublist. So for that we'll get 4 elements, we know that because here 2 total 4 elements. So now I need to check whether 10 is less than 5. No, so I need to write 5 here. Again I'll check whether 10 is less than 17. Yes, so I can write 10 here. Now again I'll check whether 40 is less than 17. No, right, 40 is not less than 17, so I'll write 17 here, 40 here. Now lastly I need to combine these two sublist. Okay, so I'll write it here. So I'll write down that. Okay, so 1, 20 and 50, 5, 10, 17 and 40. So now I need to combine them, merge them, right? So first I'll check whether 1, okay, is less than 5. Yes, so I'll write 1 here. Now 1 is done, right? So I'll move to the next value. Whether 20 is less than 5. No, 5 is the smaller value, so I need to write 5 here. So now I need to check with this value, whether 20 is less than 10. No, so I need to write 10 here. I need to move to the 17. Okay, I'll check whether 20 is less than 17. No, so I'll write 17 here and I'll check for the 40. Whether 20 is less than 40. Yes, so I need to write 20 here and I need to move to the next value here, that is 50. Whether 50 is less than 40, no, so I need to write 40 here. The remaining value is 50, so I need to write it here. Okay, so So in this way, you need to compare the values, right? Here also, you need to compare like that. So in this way, we can sort the numbers using merge sort algorithm. So this is in the ascending order. If you aren't in the descending order, then you just need to find out the maximum value here. So in the next tutorial, we'll see algorithm as well as we'll write the program for that. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.